Now we have a next topic about in chapter 2 whole numbers, properties of whole numbers. As we have seen already that this is a whole number definition, successor and exercise. The next we will come to the properties. Here in this properties, you have already come across the addition, subtraction, multiplication and divisions. These are four called as the fundamental operations. Under these fundamental operations, we will go through with the properties. The properties are in this way. You'll see one by one. First, we have property is closure property. Closure property means we will be having some equations like a plus b equal to c. In this way, we will get an equation. For that, we will see the property. This property we will get here. In this property, how these fundamental operations are undergone, you will see that in the examples. As I'll take an example, closure property 2 plus 3 equal to 5, right? Either you get take it as a 2 plus 3 or 3 plus 2. However, we get a 5. 2, 3, 5 are the any whole numbers, right? The same way, one more example, if I take that 5 plus 8 is equal to 13, right? 5 and 8 are any whole number, and if you add, you get the one more whole number. Means when you take two whole numbers and if you add, you'll get the another whole number. So in closure property under addition means plus. We'll see that. So here we're taking the example of the numbers. But any whole number you can take. So now for example, if you take 0 plus 1 also is a whole number. Because 0 is also whole number, 1 is also 0 plus 1 is get 1. So any two whole numbers when you add, you get the answer as a whole number itself. So to that we have a one here property. How it is? If A and B are any two whole numbers, then A plus B will become C. So C is also a whole number. The examples I have shown you. So here what happens? If we add any two whole numbers in any pattern, we will get the same solution. Either 2 plus 3 or 3 plus 2. So here under closure property, addition is satisfied. Now we will go to the next multiplication. As we have the four fundamentals are plus, minus, into and division. But I have seen with the addition. Now I will see with the multiplication, then I will go with the subtraction. Why I will say? Next, under multiplication. Closure property under multiplication. The same way as you have taken the statement. The statement is if A and B are any two whole numbers, then A into B becomes C. C is also a whole number. Means here it was for addition, so I took plus in between A and B. But here it is under multiplication, so I will take into. So now example, if I take that, same examples I will take 2, 3 is a will become 6. Or else if you take a 5 into 8, 5 is a 14. Or else 0 into 1 is 0. Means if you take any two whole numbers and if you multiply, you get the one more whole number itself, right? So from this you come to know that addition and multiplication both are satisfied under closure property. Because however you multiply, 2 into 3 or 3 into 2, both are same. 2 plus 3 or 3 plus 2, both are same. The same way here, these two are holds good under the closure property, that is addition and multiplication. And now I will go with this subtraction. Subtraction. Closure property under subtraction, that is minus. I'll show you the examples here. इल्ली addition and multiplication is satisfied under the closure property. So therefore